Alright team, so here is our tutorial for our enzyme experiment. Let's go.
So let me show you my setup. So here's all of our materials. We're gonna need some dish soap. I've just got some regular old dish soap. This might be helpful as well. This is just a measuring tape or some other device to measure. Or you can use that ruler app that you downloaded earlier for another lab. Here I have some measuring spoons. All right. Some hydrogen peroxide. Okay, I believe this is 3%. All right, just whatever you can find at the drugstore, like a dollar store or whatever, that should be totally fine. We don't need anything special. I have some yeast, some regular old baker's yeast. So mine is in this big package right here. You can also find it in the small packages as well. Okay, we're not gonna use very much. Maybe maximum like 5 teaspoons. I have 4 clear containers that are all roughly the same size. One of them's a little different. I didn't have quite all 4 of one size, but it is helpful that they're clear, okay? You can use regular glasses, you can use maybe some clear plastic cups, whatever you have on hand, as long as there are 4 that are clear that are roughly the same size. And I've labeled them with these sticky notes right here. Okay. And then over here I have a bowl of water that's warm tap water, okay? And then some food coloring as well that we're gonna use. All right, so our first step is I've taken about 2¼ teaspoons of this yeast right here. I measured it out, and now we're gonna dissolve it into this water. So this is warm water, it's roughly room temperature, as long as it's at least lukewarm. So this is just to activate the yeast and basically to wake it up because it's kind of been asleep for a while. Okay, so I'm just gonna dissolve it. So next we're gonna measure out 1 teaspoon of dish soap and we're gonna put it into each of these containers. So all 4 containers gets 1 teaspoon of dish soap. All right, so just so to make this reaction more visible, I'm gonna add a couple drops of food coloring to each of these. That one got a few more drops, okay. All right, and our yeast, looking pretty good, starting to wake up. See how it's starting to bubble? Okay, so we're gonna give the yeast a few more minutes. And we're gonna do our next step. To each of these 4 containers, we're gonna add different amounts of hydrogen peroxide, okay? All right, so what we have right now is we have each of our containers has soap, it has hydrogen peroxide, and it has coloring, all right? In container A, we only have soap and coloring, but let's give that a little swirl so it's all mixed up. In container B, this one right here, mine's blue. I have 1 tablespoon hydrogen peroxide, the blue food coloring, and 1 teaspoon of the dish soap. Okay, give it a little swirl. C, we have 1 teaspoon of dish soap, a little bit of green food coloring, and 2 tablespoons of the hydrogen peroxide. And in D, we have food coloring, 1 teaspoon of dish soap, and then we have the 3 tablespoons of hydrogen peroxide. All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make sure our yeast is activated, which is looking pretty good. Might wait maybe a couple more minutes till the entire surface is all foamy and bubbly. All right, and then we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of yeast to each of these 4 containers, okay? So A, B, C, and D, they all have different amounts of hydrogen peroxide in them, and we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of that yeast solution. All right, so here we go. We're gonna add in some of this yeast solution, so kind of swirl it around a little bit before you take your measurements. Okay. Yeah, so the yeast will sometimes settle on the bottom, so you just want to get it mixed into the water before you take your tablespoon. All right, and then just gently swirl it. Okay, now we're gonna let it sit for a few minutes. And while it's sitting, make sure to take your pictures.
So my joys have been sitting here probably around 10 minutes or so. And we can see that there's a distinct difference in the amount of foam that they've produced, right? And so what you'd want to do now is you'd want to take your measuring tape and see if you can measure how much foam they've produced, right? So it's not going to be exact, especially because this jar is slightly different than that jar, right? It's a little bit narrower and taller. This one's a little bit wider and shorter. But it's still a good estimate of how active that enzyme was, right? So this enzyme, catalase, we're using the yeast as the source of the enzyme here. But if you don't have any yeast, you can also use other organisms, like potato works really well, or turnips. If you just blend a piece of that, a chunk of that up, and a little bit of water, so it becomes a nice smooth mixture. So what you're going to do now is you can take these and make sure you got all your pictures done and everything, and you can wash them out, and then we're going to reuse them. And I want you to repeat this experiment, but with a different variable. All right, we're going to change something. We're going to alter one of our independent variables. And I want you to choose what you're going to alter. So altering this experiment, maybe you could maybe add some acid, see how that functions, right? So you maybe want to add some vinegar to your yeast and let the vinegars in the yeast sit for a while and see if that changes anything. Or you can add different concentrations of vinegar to each of these and see if that changes anything. You could do temperature, right? Maybe use really, really hot water for your yeast. Maybe boiling water for your yeast and see how that changes things. Or use cold water. Maybe dissolve that in ice water, okay? Use maybe a different source of catalase. Maybe try a potato or a piece of fruit or something and blend that up in some water and see if the reaction's different, okay? So you're going to change this experiment. You're going to alter one of the independent variables. We're going to try something else. I would suggest against using baking soda, because if you've ever mixed baking soda and hydrogen peroxide, you know, it kind of explodes, right? So try not to use baking soda unless you want a big mess on your hands. But just alter something else. Alter the pH. Alter the temperature of the yeast solution. Alter the organism that you use, right? Pick something, whatever it is. Change something about this experiment and then repeat it and document your results.